magnifier on it, and now I have
let me
like
leave.
Okay.
The I yellow should keep
part. No.
Now I continue.
So it says Q all the way down.
Yes, E.
E. Okay. Q E.
Okay.
All right. Q E
X.
Q E X B. Yes. Now, when the other person
okay.
gets it,
yes.
he does the same setup. First, he lines it up. The two dots.
Yes.
There.
They were talking. Yes, and he got it.
And then he loosens this pin, the screw.
And sets
it to decode.
Oh, that's the book.
Yeah. And tightens it again. And then you have to set this for the right the three, which is right there. Now, if you put that the code in, do you remember the code?
QEXD.
Press the Q. M. E.
I know.
The decoder numbers come up in red, so you know you're on the right setting. If the coded letters come up black, and the others come up purple,
I think it's
easy as that.
So could you do this, or you could do it, or something else?
Yes.
But each time when I do it, of course, this there.
Of course, yes. Because sometimes but you
so permutations is like the number of ways
that
you
can
do it. Starting from the same
thing. What happens is, for example, I press the A and it comes up as an O. The next time I press a W, another W. It skipped one. See, it didn't change.
So you see, that's important. Because there are six, if you open here, I can explain.
Right.
There are six sets of alphabets.
He's donated a
lot. Can we open?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay. So if each time that
yes.
you press, if
so
you press, you see that these are some of the steps which are missing. So it will not rotate the cylinder. If each time that you push, one time the cylinder rotates,
that time it didn't rotate.
Yes, sometimes rotates, sometimes
it doesn't. No, next time it didn't rotate.
If each time it rotated, then you could decipher by just reading the text, because there is a repetition, there is a pattern.
Every six letters.
Each time that I press, it's one time rotating, one time not rotating.
Depending on where this is set. See, if I set it to...
Okay, I want my $5 commission. Come on.
It will change the letter every time you press the key. Because there's teeth all the way around.
Come on.
But the next one, there's two teeth missing. Mm-hmm. So when it gets to this point.
So moving that corresponds to permutation here.
Yes,
right?
Exactly. So when I set it here, it's going to miss a turn. Mm-hmm. Now this time it didn't.
Uh-huh. Okay, now it rotates. So
right.
It's not 2-1.
Right.
Twice it rotates.
It'll rotate again. Now it won't rotate.
Okay. This one is ours.
And the next time it does.
It does. Now it does not.
Right.
Now it does.
Well, that doesn't look like
now it does again.
Yeah. Right. And if
so
I set it.
Because if it rotated every time,
yeah.
then letter E would correspond periodically to what appears here.
Yes, yes.
Okay, G, whatever.
Yeah, sure.
But now that some steps are missing,
yes.
it would not be anymore like this. There's a random.
I understand. That's why I'm saying there is a randomness. But why do we call it permutation?
Oh, I can't.
It's not a mathematical permutation.
May I press a key?
I don't know why you call it that. Yes, please.
I'd like to try to press a key.
Sure. No, the terminology. I'm not sure whether
maybe there is something good about permutation.
No.
No?
It's
no?
That the people that built the machine in Germany decided to call this setting permutation rather than a setting or a something else.
I
a position.
Okay, so that the whole alphabet is how many of those?
There's six sets.
Six sets.
Code and decode. They're always in a set.
Six pairs.
Six pairs. And they're interchangeable.
I think we have to close down, people.
I hate to tell it to you,
but we've got to close up shop.
Are you Professor Rescher?
I am.
I'm Marta Levitska from the London Park.
Oh, hi.
Nice to meet you.
Yes. Oh, yes.
We'll reassemble it.